I would say that the conference has become the place where there has been now a formal acknowledgement that treatment is prevention. And when I talk about treatment, it's not just my work on antiretroviral therapy preventing HIV transmission, which is certainly an integral component of that, but what people have realized is that optimizing treatment, for example, optimal management of the drug abuse in individual is going to be fundamental to achieve better outcomes for the individual, engage them on antiretroviral therapy, and therefore control the epidemic. So in other words, we shall not be able to control the HIV epidemic if we don't address comprehensively the problem of drug addiction. And this is not about incarcerating drug addicted individuals, because then what we're doing, we're transferring the center, the epicenter of the epidemic to the correctional system, and then the correctional system becomes part of the problem as opposed to part of the solution. It's time that we realize that there is a better way of doing business. It's more compassionate, it's more caring, it's actually more effective, it's more cost effective, and it will lead to a curbing of the HIV epidemic and many other epidemics in the way. A number of years ago, back in the, at the Toronto conference, we presented for the first time something that it was borderline controversial, if you want. We had come across sufficient data, we felt, to clearly put the hypothesis forward that expanding coverage with antiretroviral therapy could be an essential component of the strategy to curb both AIDS-related morbidity and mortality, and additionally, HIV transmission. the early going was a little bit difficult, but I must say thanks to the encouragement of a number of people, including Nora Bolkov from the National Institute of Drug Abuse, and her passion and her true encouragement, beyond the fact that NIDA was willing to fund the work, we pursued. And then upon us prospectively re-engaging on a program of active expansion of antiretroviral therapy, we brought the numbers up for people treated with HIV infection, and that led to a new decrease in HIV new diagnosis. Most interesting, because we had a specific outreach component of that in the intravenous drug using community, we saw a 50% decrease on HIV new infections over the last 3 years of the study that was reported today in The Lancet. And let me make it clear that we were able to not only show this ecological association twice, but we were also able to show last year in a very carefully controlled cohort study that decreasing viral load was decreasing viral load as a result of increasing antiretroviral therapy in a cohort of intravenous drug users was associated with decreased HIV incidence. So while for the population study we were measuring a new diagnosis, in the subset study that we published in the British Medical Journal last year, we actually look at actual incidence. And beyond that, it's important to recognize that during all this time, we had increasing number of HIV tests being done in the province every year, so that we are finding less new cases despite more testing. So the conclusion is very simple and straightforward. If we expand antiretroviral therapy within current therapeutic guidelines, and by the way, I had to tell you, current therapeutic guidelines are evolving very rapidly. We put out yesterday the IES USA new guidelines saying that you should treat nearly everybody. So there is plenty of room here to do good for the people and for the public, because if you optimize coverage within therapeutic guidelines, you will derive a substantial decrease on HIV transmission. Even at a time of a serious fiscal crisis, there is very little else that you can do that is going to give you this return on investment. And given the fact that HIV in the absence of treatment is bad for the person and bad for society, we believe that the data that we have put together really should re-energize the role of antiretroviral therapy, not just in North America, in Canada, in the United States, whatever, but in the rest of the world, because this is a way to solve the epidemic, solve the problem for the patients, for the affected, the infected, for the at-risk, for the injection drug-using communities, and really for everybody. It makes actually treatment of drug addicted populations part of a package that is highly cost effective because of a secondary benefit that we never thought of.